It must be foldable season. Last month brought us Google's first foray into the foldable phone market, the Pixel Fold. And now, we've got Samsung's latest revisions to their foldable lineup, the Z Fold5 and the Z Flip5. We've already tackled the Fold in another video, so today we're looking at the smaller of the two, the Galaxy Z Flip5. As always, our friends at Creative Electron came through with these amazing Xrays of the Z Flip 5. The complexity of the engineering as a whole is on display here, and it's apparent making a foldable device is really no easy feat. You'd think all the complications of making a foldable device would also make the disassembly that much more complicated, but the Flip 5's design is actually pretty straightforward. A little heat and some gentle prying gets me a gap between the phone and the back panel, and then by using a pick, I'm able to gently separate the panel from the phone, and then peel it right up. Repeating the same process for the rear display, I'm able to lift it away, but I do need to disconnect the display cable to fully remove it. A few screws secure the upper metal frame, and then it pops right off. Down below, we've got a couple more screws securing the wireless charging coil. Once those are removed, just peel the coil back to remove it. Before we can get to the batteries, I've got one more shield on the bottom of the phone that's hiding the haptic engine, the USB-C port, and some cables that crisscross the battery. I've got more cables on the upper section of the phone to disconnect, and now I have full access to the batteries. Hey, these batteries have pull tabs, and not only that, they're some of the easiest battery pull tabs I've had to deal with. Both the top and bottom batteries pop out with just a little effort, hardly leaving any mess behind. Awesome. The larger battery is rated at 10.16 watt-hours, and the smaller one comes in at less than half that with 3.88 watt-hours, for a combined capacity of 14.04 watt-hours. This is just slightly lower than the 18.83 watt-hour battery we found in the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. All it takes to remove the two remaining boards is a little prying with our spudger. We've got the main board, and the lower board, which is home to some microphones, and the USB-C port. Now, all that's left is the display. These foldable AMOLED panels are very cool, but the process of removing them is not. The bezels surrounding the display are essentially consumables, meaning they're not meant to be reused for reassembly. Removing these bezels is a slow process that frequently involves breaking them. Once you've got all the bezels removed, you're left with the display. This flexible display is backed by two metal plates, so I need to make sure that we're getting under that metal plate during disassembly. It's incredibly easy to slip up and find your prying tool in between the display's many layers, which is a quick way of destroying it. Other than that, the adhesive holding the display isn't too tough. It only needs some mild heat to lift it away. With the panel out of the way, we can take a closer look at Samsung's latest iteration of the Flip's hinge mechanism. Creative Electron's X-rays clearly show that unlike the Fold 4 and Fold 5, the Flip continues to use a gear-based hinge mechanism. Given the move away from geared hinge mechanisms in the Fold line, I'm left wondering why they're still in the Flip 5. It might be they just haven't figured out a way to introduce an alternative folding mechanism into such a tight space. It definitely seems like Samsung has dialed in their foldable design, and as a result, not a ton has changed this year. Getting into the Z Flip 5 has the same heating and prying solutions we've seen in the past, and once you're inside, the layout is pretty much the same simple and easy layout to navigate. The batteries this year are the real MVPs. The new pull tabs make the removal process so much easier, it's really a treat. Want more foldables content? Make sure you're subscribed to our channel because we've got you covered with our recent teardowns of the Pixel Fold and the recently released Z Fold 5.